Using your camera's white balance incorrectly can make you look awfully orange or smurfy. In this video, I'm going to show you how to stop setting white balance to auto and how it really works. But first, let's make a little pact together. Repeat after me. I solemnly swear I will never shoot in auto white balance. Every time I hit record, I will manually set the white balance based on my current lighting situation. Okay, now that that's out of the way, there are quite a few built-in options for white balance on a DSLR or a video camera, which you can access by pressing the white balance button if you have one, or finding them deeper in the quick menus. There's auto, daylight, shade, cloudy, tungsten, fluorescent, flash, custom, and kelvin, in which you can manually set the color temperature. First, let's talk about the dangers of auto white balance. When you leave the camera in auto white balance while shooting, it can manually change while recording, which is a huge nightmare when it comes to editing. With photography, it doesn't really matter because you can change that in Lightroom or Photoshop later with a simple slider, but in video, changing white balance when it's changing throughout your video is basically unfixable. Now, if you happen to be in an environment exactly like one of the presets where you're outside during the day or you're only using tungsten lights in your house, then you can use one of those, but most of the time you're going to need to set it to something custom using Kelvin. Kelvin is a measurement of color temperature. Tungsten bulbs that you see inside your home at nighttime are around 3200, daylight balanced are about 5600. The lights I'm using to shoot this video are daylight balanced, so the white balance I'm using is 5600 Kelvin. Now you can also use the custom white balance option and use something like a big white reflector or just a white piece of paper to set it manually, which is a little bit harder to do, but it's helpful if you're in a weird circumstance. So that's it for white balance, and going right alongside with white balance, other important settings that you definitely need to know how to use on your camera manually are aperture, shutter speed, and ISO. Well, yesterday I released a free ebook called Understanding the Exposure Triangle that will walk you exactly how to start using your camera in manual mode, from aperture setting to picking the right shutter speed and setting the right ISO based on which camera you have. You can download the book for free at diyvideoguy.com/exposure. And that wraps up this video. In the next video, I'll show you how I take a 6-second Vine and a 15-second Instagram, and I combine them into a 21-second monster. That was creepy. And until then, remember, if you're gonna do it, might as well do it on video.